I'm Dave Hoy, agronomist with Great Lakes Hybrids. Today I'd like to talk to you about submerged corn and saturated soils. With the recent rains that we've had, I get a lot of calls about how long will my corn last in these saturated soil conditions, or even when there's water over the corn. Now when you have soils like this where the water is sitting, what that water does, it depletes the soil of oxygen. It pushes all the oxygen out of the soil. It takes about 48 hours for it to remove all the oxygen. And those little corn plants, they need oxygen to be able to breathe. And that's bad for that corn. Also, if you have corn that is underwater, completely submerged, then we're talking about temperature. If it's hot out, above 70 degrees, that submerged corn may not last 24 hours. However, if you have corn that is taller, V6 and taller, and it's a little cooler out, that corn may last a little bit longer than that, 3 to 5 days, depending on the temperature and the height of the corn. The bigger the corn, the better a chance it has of surviving. The other questions I get regarding, in these saturated soils, how much nitrogen have I lost? And generally figured every 5 days that you're sitting in saturated soils, you've lost 25% of your nitrogen. So what should a guy do? When you have areas in your fields that are drowned out, if you think that there's going to be an opportunity to replant or get a crop out of it, you can always go in and put some nitrogen on. If you have larger areas where the corn survived and yet you lost some nitrogen, you can think about going in with some side dress. And I always tell guys, only side dress if you feel like you're going to get a pretty good crop out of there. There's no reason spending $50 just to get $10 back. So when we get into those replant situations, we always have to think about, can I plant something in there that's going to grow? Should I put corn in, or should I switch it over to beans? And I always recommend, boy, do as little damage to the soil as you can, because you've got some herbicide down there that's still active, and the more you get in there and fiddle with it, the more weeds you're going to bring up. And speaking of that, if you do go and switch it over to soybeans, you do have to remember what herbicide you put down in the first place. If you've got a dicamba or an atrazine type product down there, those soybeans probably not going to grow. Hopefully that answers some of your questions about submerged corn. The last thing I'll leave you with is, how do you evaluate the corn to see if it's going to live or not? And I always go by this. If I could pull that corn out that was saturated or even submerged, and you split it right down the middle and you look at the growing point. If that growing point is white, you're going to be all right. If the growing point is brown, you just well plow her down. Thanks for listening, and I'll see you later.